What is up, guys? Full Suit Gaming here, and this is episode 2 of the multiplayer server without a name. So, since the last episode, a lot has been done. Here's my house so far, and today I am going to be making a new house that's actually good, as opposed to a 2x2 house. Check it out. Pretty easy. But let's just go check out what other people have to do. I'm gonna go run to craft the enchanting table because I have 30 levels. And enchant a pickaxe. So, got some people online right now. Over here we got Extreme and Radioactive Space. Ooh, left this. I'm gonna get this. Free Sugar King. Sweet. Alright. We also lit up a lot of spawn, spawn island, so there aren't that many mobs, but mobs have destroyed the environment a lot. I hate when people choose like this and just grab this. Alright. Got Extreme's house. Pretty nice. Liggy's house is over there. Tennis fan's house. Skelly spawner / grinder, but it's not working right now. And let's get some more. Here's Coley's lighthouse thing. I'm not sure what he's doing with it, but it's pretty interesting. And then we are at spawn. So somebody told me this trick with the enchanting tables, and I'm going to sort of see if it works again, because the first time I used it, I got this nice pick, Silk Touch 1, Unbreaking 3, and we're going to see if it works. So, the deal is, we have to craft the pickaxe first. Okay, so the deal is, if you have, let me find it. If you see this symbol right here, the three little dots? If you have that as the last thing on your enchanting, it gives you something good. Extreme taught me this, and he's gotten Fortune 3 and stuff from it, so I'm gonna try it. So, let's see if this works again. Alright, this is probably going to take a while. I'll come back when I get it. Okay guys, so I got the little three dots and triangle symbol. Let's see what we get. And there you go, it worked. Fortune 3, Efficiency 4, and Breaking 3. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Now I have the two good pickaxes. I was hoping I would get an efficiency 4 and breaking 3, but for mining and whatnot. But these are great. I'm not gonna complain about them. So let's get on with the house. Yep. I shouldn't see many mobs around my actual base, but in the forest it's sort of sketchy. So as you know, these sheep are there for a reason. It's for wool, which is going to be a large material of the house. So let's get out all the stuff we're using. Some cobble. wood. I'm probably gonna have to, I might have to get some more wood, probably. And then some wool. So basically, I'm planning on making a water mill house in this little river between the two islands. Even though it's not actual running water, it's going to be for looks. Jeez. I hate this game. I want to kill myself. Oh my god. Just stop! Skeletons are literally the worst thing ever. Look at this. It's horrible. Okay, so anyway, what I was going to do was mark out where I'm building the house. So, check out the land. Alright guys, I am back. There's quite a few people online, and gotten some more wood, and I've laid out my house, essentially. So, let's go ahead and get started. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so here's the house so far. Definitely it's gonna need some work, but this is the basic design. Sorry for all the drama in the chat. People are just like not too mature today, so you know, gotta do something about that. But I've been looking at the house. I actually made a change while I was building. What I had was basically a log going up here and a log going up here. And so all of these wall panels were 3 blocks by 3 blocks. However, I extended it out. So we have a 1 5 by 3 panel. But what that does to this side is it gives this sort of weird thing in here. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do is put a chimney there. I'm deciding whether to make that chimney out of stone brick, because that might actually go nice with the colors, but brick might also look nice, so I'm going to be working on that. But that's it for this episode, guys. I'll see you next time.